Very good evening to you. Thank you for joining us. Welcome to Sports Tonight. This is the fourth edition of Sports Tonight for the week, and we have a very, very lively show lined up for you this Monday. My name is Toyin Bitoye. Let me quickly give you an idea of what we'll be doing on the program tonight. Remember, it's a Monday night, and what we usually do on Mondays majorly is to review some of the major talking points around domestic football in Nigeria. It's not going to be any different tonight. We'll be giving you a review of Nigeria Professional Football League Match Day 17 results. We will also, on the program tonight, be taking a look at the log, find out which teams are at the top. We will also be talking about the marksmen. Believe it or not, we've had five hat-tricks already this season after just 17 rounds of matches. And that looks to me like an amazing return of goals. Alright, so you'll find out exactly who the top marksmen are around our domestic football so that you can follow and understand exactly what is happening in the league. Alright, so it's also been a season of coaches being hired, being fired. We'll talk about, give you the story of three coaches on the program tonight. You'll find out which coaches we're talking about. Just stick around and enjoy every bit of what we have on offer for you. We will go abroad, of course, touch up a little bit on the last games of the season. Yemi Adebayo will be joining us for that part of the show. Yemi is a very, very happy man because Arsenal somehow have done it again, finishing ahead of Tottenham Hotspur on the last day of the season. What a dramatic end to the EPL. So we'll talk about it on the program tonight. We will also be taking a look at some issues around our football administratively. Of course, the major talking point for us tonight will be the planned visit of FIFA President Gianni Infantino to Nigeria in a few weeks from now. What lessons can we hope to learn, or what advantages will this offer Nigerian football if the FIFA president pays a visit to Nigeria? How do we take advantage of that to help to solidify the gains of football in Nigeria? So those are some of the issues we will touch upon on the program this Monday. So I want to ask you to stay around and be a part of the show and be active with us, interact with us, and let us make this show as exciting, as fun-filled as possible. All right, and of course, let me start off this way. Tell you that you have to be a part of the show. You have to talk to us. We want to hear from you. That's the way we put it. We like to hear from you. You have a role to play to be active on this show and to interact with us on this show, taking advantage of what you've seen on your screen for feedback. All right, on Facebook, on Twitter, the address and those handles are there for you to talk to us on the program tonight. Give us your thoughts, your opinion, what you feel about these issues as we go along on Sports Tonight. And let's also tell you that you can watch us on www.channelstv.com as well as on youtube.com/channelsweb. If you want to view us on your device, maybe it's BlackBerry or iPhone or iPad, it's as simple as ABC. Just click on m.channelstv.com and you are on to your home for the news. And I'm telling you, it is seamless 24/7. It gets better if you download the channels app for Android, iOS, Windows from their respective stores. It keeps channels at your fingertips and makes you track everything that goes on Channels TV, not just the sports. You can track the business, you can track health, you can track entertainment, everything that there is to the award-winning package called Channels TV. You get it right there at your fingertips. All right, so, and as you do all of that, don't forget to tell us where your comments are coming from. We'd like to appreciate you from wherever part of the world you're watching us from, so that we can appreciate you a little more on the show. All right, so that's the way we want you to be a part of the show, via feedback, and we're expecting that you'll be able to talk to us as well. All right, I think I should start off the show. Let's start from home. Let's start from taekwondo. Let's start from this young lad. Well, not getting any younger. He's becoming a man by the day. I'm going to talk about Olympiad Chika Chukwumerije. Of course, he was a former captain of Team Nigeria to the Olympic Games. And you know what Chika has been doing. He's been trying to raise young taekwondoists to replace the aging ones, and he's been doing that. And he says there is urgent need for us to begin to pay more attention to grooming young athletes so that we can replace these aging stars. He's one of them. He's an Olympic medalist, and he believes that we have to, develop a lot more Chikachukwu Emerijes for Nigeria to excel. He has a foundation called the Chikachukwu Emerijes Sports Foundation, and at the weekend, they concluded a three-day training workshop for young taekwondoists, and that workshop was a huge success, attracting athletes from 20 states of the federation. And we cannot commend Chikachukwu Emerijes enough for what he's been able to do. And at the same time, we cannot also commend enough the Taekwondo Federation of Nigeria, led by George Ashiru. But let's listen now to Chikachukwu Emerijes, and then we'll be back with more for you on Sports Tonight.
Every year, it gets better and better in the quality of youth athletes I see. So, first of all credit to the coaches. They are doing a good job of discovering them. And for this edition, we are confident that, like the previous edition, that on Earth, Commonwealth gold medalists like Shola Olowokere and Issa Abubakar Adamu, we are confident that this group will also go ahead to start dominating the nationals in the next 1 or 2 years. It's very good. It's been all inclusive. When you look at like the quality of resource persons that came in, you have African champions, you have Commonwealth champions, national and university champions that came to interact with the kids. They are the ones cornering them, coaching them, teaching them how to referee, how to run and all that. So the 9 sections in 3 days has been very hectic, and the workshop has been a huge success.
They developed an understanding of the game and the rules the referee used, his hand signals and everything. It just shows that even though we fight those that we know, we should just know that it's a team building exercise. So no matter the win, no matter the defeat, don't rub it in the other's faces. So it just shows that, yes, we're all learning together.
Yeah, I like that. Shows that we're all learning together. And I want you to keep your eyes on that young lad. In a few years, that could be the next world champion, the next Olympic gold medalist for Nigeria. It's very regrettable, though, that Taekwondo will not be at the Rio Olympics for Nigeria. We hope that everybody involved with Taekwondo in Nigeria, we've learned a few lessons as to the reasons why we will not be having Taekwondo at the Rio Olympics for Nigeria. We'll learn the lesson and make sure that those kind of mistakes, those kind of slips, do not happen anymore. All right, from Taekwondo, let's talk about the sports minister now. We're getting ready, of course, for the Rio Olympics, and there's a lot of agitation everywhere in the media about how Team Nigeria is getting ready. And there's a common factor to all of the discourse about Nigeria at the Olympic Games when people talk about not being adequately prepared. It's funding, the issue of funding. And the sports minister, Barrister Solomon Dalung, has challenged all sports federations to begin to find a creative way of getting funds to run their programs. So let's pause a little bit, listen to Barrister Solomon Dalung, Honorable Sports Minister, Federal Ministry of Youth and Sports, talk about sports federations and now they should be able to find a creative way of getting funds to run their programs and not wait for government all the time. And of course, he was commending the Nigeria Tennis Federation for what they've been able to do, and some other federations as well who have also been able to find a way of getting funds to run their program. So let's listen to the sports minister now, and then we'll be back with more for you on Sports Tonight.
And I think the challenges this tournament today has thrown to other federations is the over-dependency on government crying cap in hand for support. There is so much that every federation can do. All they need to do is to boost their credentials. Once you are credible, everybody can do business with you. The tennis now is supported, is sponsored by investors because they believe in what is going on there. There is transparent management of funds and all is going well. Tennis shall soon take over from football if football do not put their house in order.